Rush Duel, Donut the Battle Royale, it is. Let me tell you something. Yu-Gi-Oh! Rush Duel, Dawn of the Battle Royale. We thought we'd never see how the duel disc would form from being, you know, a 5-slate format to a 3-slate. Then there's things called Maximum Monsters and Legendary Monsters. Now, the first appearance of Yu-Gi-Oh! 7's anime, Maximum Monster is a subtype of a monster that different parts to be summoned together. Also, Maximum Attack were replaced by the original attacks. Wow. When all the parts of the Maximum Monsters are in the field, Maximum Monster could also continue as a effect monster. Now, as an effect which lasts, they are on the field. Now, it's like, how can I put it? Seriously, how can I put it? It's like Exodia, but with three monsters. I mean, it says, the history of Maximum Monsters in the anime starts with the creation of Neil Tsunoji from the gaps in program left by Yuga, the main character, Odo, in Rush Duel's rules for further addition. Which means, guess what? Wow. And here's where the Exodia card steps in. While the primary of Exodia declares an automatic win when they all have all five pieces in the forbidden one, the other way to use it. Now, like I said, it's like Exodia, but with different ways. I mean, the Forbidden One allows you to claim automatic victory, while the Maximum Overload, how you pronounce it, has their own little abilities. I mean, one that allows it to power up based on how many life points you have, or, you know. And then there's a Aztec Flyers. I think that was a cousin. Autoflag Jet something was the second cards that you learn how to use. I forgot what this one do. And then, this monster here, wow, by itself is only 2,000 attack, but together, 4,000, the spells, cancel out spells, traps, certain monster effects, we like, wow. Once again, wow. And this one right here. This monster right here. Let me tell you something about this monster. No lie. If you have, again, another one that, if you have less life points, it powers up. Also, a piercing attack. That's most of the Maximum Monsters. Then, I never knew it had its own Maximum Summoning. My Multi-Dragon Strike. Wow. I never read it. I like it. It's like the Egyptian gods, but crazier. And then here was the final Yuga Odo's Maximum Monsters. Who knew? Superior vs. Magnum. Overload. Beast like monsters. Wow. Then let me talk on the legend cards. The legend cards. An exclusive card series that Yu-Gi-Oh! 7's anime used to play homage to the cards using the original Yu-Gi-Oh! Series. These cards have the legend icon shown on their status. So far, in known, each duelist can only have one legend card in their deck. Oh, I'm going to talk about it because this guy told me about this. And you're wondering, why are legends? If you look back at the original series, you understand. These legends have everything. Especially my dog, the Dark Magician. With ritual summonings, fusion summonings, regular summonings based on the original ritual summonings. Fusion summons that we never knew existed. I mean, this boy has been in legendary battles. Legendary battles. Like the one with Joey Wheeler, Seto Kaiba, Merrick. Someone please call the doctor. I'm about to have a heart attack. And there's one more thing I would like to talk about. I'm going to have to really do very hard on this. Think very hard. Because even the duels with Arcania, it makes me still think. What was wrong with a guy who used Dark Magician working for evil man like Merrick? Do you know what I'm saying? And then, why he's truly legendary? Because this monster here showed up in his last appearance in a movie. Dark Side of Dimensions. That's why he got a legend icon. Because he's a legend. Yes. And then there was another thing I want to talk about. Just like how they do in the manga, the anime, and one particular game. Seriously, I ain't gonna lie. In Yu-Gi-Oh! Rush Duel, Dawn of the Battle Royal, they have something that nobody would think to, how can I put it, figure out. Especially with the, in this version. I'm going to talk about later. Yu-Gi-Oh! Sakyo card battle. I'm wondering, are they dueling with those dual discs? But as you can see right there on the bottom, behind the main character, you see two kids dueling. That's right, dueling right there. I'm not lying. Why does the monster show up? Some up there waving, some up there, you know, demanding attacks. When is this going to happen? That's how crazy this game is. And I've been wondering this. I've been pondering this. Whatever happened to the duel between Atem and Seto Kaiba in Dark Side of Dimensions? That's crazy. Very crazy. I would like to know what really happened. Who won the final battle between the Pharaoh and Seto Kaiba? Oh, yes!
Yeah, baby.
So with that being said, I'm your boy, Chris Blackthorne Harris. Subscribe, hit that notification bell, like, share, leave a comment below. Tell me what you think about this Yu-Gi-Oh! Video. Because when it comes to my dueling, it's time to duel.